Hello guys, my name is Kristijan and I am a lead blockchain solution specialist working on Revuto's infrastructure for custodial wallet. Today I'm gonna talk about troubleshooting and everything what we had in a mobile wallet and how our development roadmap was being made over the last few months. So you already have the Revuto's non-custodial wallet, and I must emphasize that we have over 50k or 50,000 people generated the non-custodial wallets and over 300,000 people registered and using Revuto's mobile application. So with the mobile wallets, and when we started the journey implementing the mobile wallets, reason why we wanted to do that is because we wanted to follow the principle, your money, your keys. And because of that, we wanted to offer you a complete solution for receiving the airdrops of the tokens. We could use the custodial principle, but we wanted to mitigate that and completely give you your tokens, which you get from the token sale itself. So how we started to doing the mobile wallet development, the first stop for us was to understand the BIPs and CIPs. So you need to understand that every blockchain has its own standards. BIPs are standard for the Bitcoin protocol, and most of the blockchain projects and most of the wallets you use are using those BIPs in their HDE wallet infrastructure, hierarchical deterministic wallets, which basically means they use the BIP39 standard to generate mnemonics and the seed phrase, while after that they use BIP32, actually BIP44, to generate the HDE wallet path. In Cardano, the story is a bit different. The Cardano found out the possible issues and the possible small subgroup attacks on the elliptic curve, which is being used by BIP standards, and they implemented AD25519 generation method to mitigate all the risks around that particular possible attacks. Because of that, we were unable to use already produced, tested libraries, which you have for the native iOS application if you want to implement anything what works with the Qt protocol, or if you want to implement anything what works with the EVM engine. So we needed to completely do the R&D and find what we can do and what we can implement in those kind of non-custodial wallets for the mobile devices. Our research led us to the Yaroi, where we found it's being done in React Native. You have the whole code posted on the GitHub, but we wanted to have more native approach and have it like iOS native application, because we already have a product, which centralized product for subscription management, which has already been done in iOS native language, which is Swift, and we wanted to do the same for the Android in Kotlin language. So our journey led us to start researching how we are going to implement that. I was the guy who was actually doing that, and to be honest, I failed tremendously, because it was unable to have some sustainable and vetted and production-proved generation of the mnemonics and the seeds with the libraries which Cardano had in that point of time. So we need to figure out another way how to do it, how to implement that, and how to, you know, when you do some libraries from the different languages, when you compile it or interpret it, you need to understand that you have multiple runtimes inside. So orchestrating all those runtimes and asynchronous functioning is really, really heavy job to do. So what we started to researching how we can implement maybe a JS, because you all know that there is a possibility to run a JS in a container of the Swift or the Android, and we started doing that way, and that was successful. The problem which we found out with the JS is that we will need really to understand what we need to bring out from the libraries. So what we did, we found out the JS libraries on the GitHub, and we completely separated and just took what we need and only that small piece of code to generate the wallets. Everything was left aside what we didn't need. So our code base was, let's say, clean JS for generating the whole wallet infrastructure combined with the iOS. That gave us some stability, but what we didn't know at that point of time is what possible problems could be in future because no one did it. We are the first who did that with that methodology. So it was really a challenge for us to see how it's going to behave in the production. To have all that, to provide you a wallet with all those capabilities and with the design and all the UTXO parsing, we needed to set up our own infrastructure. So if you want to run any kind of wallet or staking pools or whatever on Cardano network, you need those three components. You need a node, which is classic blockchain node being synced with the rest of the nodes on the network. The second thing which you need is DebeSync. DebeSync is a mechanism where you put that component behind the node and it's listened for a node and translate the UTXO based data into more relational human readable formats so that you can be sure that you can write the queries in a way developers are used to, you know, because parsing the UTXO is challenging because if you want to parse UTXO, you need to be really, really, really experienced with shell scripting or some low-code level scripting to get all from the blockchain and parse it into readable data. DebeSync is actually built on top of PostgreSQL, and they did a great job, but the problem with the nodes and everything is that you cannot cluster them. So one node is one instance for itself. If it goes down, we tried like 10 different options. We tried to do the snapshot before going down. We were listening if there is a load so that we can put the snapshot next time when we are firing the node again and when we are building it again to put the snapshot behind so that we can lower the sync rate, but it's not possible. And I was thinking why, but there is a common sense when you look at it. It's a fine fintech, so you have 8 decimals. You have Lovelace, which is the smallest unit of Cardano. It needs to be completely precise in the last decimal in every record. So Cardano node, what it does when the DebeSync sees that it needs to sync again, Cardano node actually fires the event to the DebeSync, which basically cleans the whole PostgreSQL, truncate the whole database, and start from the beginning. That process takes time. Blockchain is getting bigger and bigger, but the solution which we did is that we scale and now we are running more than 5 nodes. 5 to 10 nodes are actually currently up and running in our infrastructure so that we can mitigate all the risks, all the challenges which we have in the past. So iOS and Android libs, JS, I already mentioned that. The thing with them, I think soon, based on what I saw in Catalyst programs, we will be able to remove them and really be native iOS and Android application, because there is an initiative to create SDK libraries around the Cardano ecosystem based on a SaaS model. I see that some development crew is actually want to raise the funds for that, to do that, and I'm really keen to see how they are going to develop it. If that's going to be the case, I think we will have more stable and better, much, much better product in a non-custodial space. Also, what you need to understand is that I think there is new era coming, because most of our customers are non-experienced customers and we really want to educate them and give them to be their, let's say, their Gandalf for the blockchain. But you need to understand that it takes time to learn and to digest everything. So non-custodial and custodial wallets, yes, they are completely two different types of wallets, but I think they are past and the new age of wallets are coming. It's called MPC wallets. It's multi-party computational wallets. So what is that? It's a combination of custodial and non-custodial wallets, where basically, for example, in Revuto's example, we can do like Revuto can offer you a computation where your keys are actually your keys, but also we are part of your key generation. What that means, if something happens to you, you can recover. If you lose your part, Revuto can recover your key and your wallet. But on the other hand, Revuto cannot spend any kind of your money without your consent. It's more like, imagine it like multi-signature wallet, but it's not based on multi-sig addresses. It's based on multi-party computational on a level of generating root master key. That's totally two different sites. And I don't know when we are going to implement that or if we are going to implement that soon. I just wanted to use Revuto as an example, because if you ask me, I would like to have some responsible for my money, but still be able to control the spending of that money. That's how I see that banks should work, for example. But of course, banks are doing whatever they want. I want to touch base on the issues being resolved, because we are not escaping them. We do not want to hide them. Issues are there. We are going to have issues in future. Those who are breaking the walls, they have issues. You know, we could wait for someone to do it and then just follow the road, but we wanted to be first. So the first issue why wallet was not working during the listing was the node synchronization, which I already explained. It was just a matter of runtime synchronization, which we had there, and a lot of traffic came to our node, and the node was unable to process it. Like I said, it's impossible to scale it in a cluster mode because it's one-on-one, so we needed to figure out how to load balance all the requests in the future. Now it's done. The second thing, mobile runtime. Sometimes you cannot predict that JS runtime will be late and the iOS runtime will not be able to wait for the function execution, and it will continue the process without, for example, having an address generator or having the payment keys submitting the transactions. Some things like that happened. There were like minor issues, really small issues, but when you look from the user experience side, it means like nothing is working. But in reality, it was really small minor issue. And of course, like I already said, scalability. With the non-custodial feature, we are not those who can control any kind of transaction submitting, because node cannot be push it in cluster mode. So we needed to figure out how we are going to scale the request coming from the mobile sites. Now I think we successfully managed all of that, and that in future our idea is to push more gamification or play to earn models into mobile wallet itself. We want to get more interaction with you guys, because we think that it's all about bringing the community inside. So this lesson, or let's say this video was the intention for this video was to explain you that we are controlling our troubleshooting, and that we think that we are going to bring more trust level to you, and we just need your patience, you know, and your help to give us, let's say, comprehensive argumented feedbacks and what's happening, to get more involved in the Revuto product, and then you will get better product from us. Thank you for listening. And as I said, if you have any comments, if you have any ideas, if you have anything what you want to suggest, please write it down, and I'm keen to answer to you. Thank you.